What's happening, people? Back with another reaction, back with some more Tears for Fears. And we're going back to the 1996 compilation album, Saturnine Martial and Lunatic. And we're up to the tune, Tears Roll Down. It speaks to not just tears, but tears that are so heavy or in such large volume that they're actually rolling down your cheeks. So I feel like it suggests an emotional state of considerable power or intensity. Now, you can cry for different reasons. You can cry because you are genuinely sad or distraught. You can cry because you are sort of overwhelmed by the sort of intensity of a moment, whether that's like artistic sublimity or just sort of the totality of experience. You can also weep because you are so happy and joyful that actually your experience of excitement and happiness is just so overwhelming that it sort of causes the most intense physiological reaction possible, even though, again, tears are normally associated with sadness. So, I feel like it could be both more joyous or more depressive, but ultimately it speaks to an intense emotional state. Whether it's the person, the narrator of the song, or whether it's a sort of a face that they are seeing, whether, you know, a person actually in front of them, or perhaps on a video screen. I feel like you can go some different ways with it, but it speaks to a strong level of emotion such that it engages the sort of physiological or biological aspects of our existence, which is to say, you know, sometimes our minds go through such intense experiences that our bodies can do little but try to sort of accommodate and account for that experience. So, in any case, let's find out. This is Tears for Fears. The tune is Tears Roll Down, and it's on the 1996 compilation album Saturnine Martial and Lunatic. Hey. Kind of island dancing vibe. Thank you. that's insane. Like, it would have been already interesting if it was the first couple minutes and the sort of kind of tribal feel. Again, it felt maybe lamentative, like an energetic sort of wake. And then suddenly in comes the voice, in comes, I think, piano, in comes a like fuller, you know, sort of a more traditional song type of feel. So it was a really interesting development that I was not expecting, but I think it was pulled off brilliantly. Is this another solo Roland piece? It feels like the last few where I've asked that, they have been like from around the time of this release, so during a period when Kurt was not in the group. And again, I feel like the more experimental tracks in their catalog, it feels like they're more perhaps Roland related in terms of the composition production, even during periods when Kurt was there. Nevertheless, a cool tune, and one that, like I said, it would have already been very interesting to me, and I would have said a lot about the, you know, kind of tribal percussion. Feels like there's some chimes, almost like a steel drum kind of feel, so it gave me that kind of Islander vibe. Although, again, the tribal style vocals felt sort of like forlorn, or at least not entirely consonant and enthusiastic. So yeah, I already would have had a lot to say, and then that song part came in the latter stages and it sort of took it to another level. So really cool, again, maybe more experimental, but in a very compelling and interesting way. So let me know if you agree. We'll see you next time. Peace.